Indian public institutions have made tremendous, very, very perceptible progress. In fact, a key argument that we've been is that if you apply your mind to a problem, you begin by recognizing that you have a problem on hand. Right? And with gender, that recognition is very, very real. For example, within my own institution, about a third of all tenure-track faculty members recruited in the last 8 years have been women. That didn't happen automatically. I mean, institutions have been making a very, very concerted effort in making. Except that all forms of diversity actions are not treated. So gender is recognized as important diversity.
One last question.
Okay.
See, now the IIMs have been, you know, I have been also part of this group fighting for, you know, the reservations in HPM, right? Yeah. Now they have this Brahmin 10% reservation. I would say that. Okay.
Do you think
at least they'll start now implementing affirmative action? So,
punctures a big hole into the meritocracy.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Interesting to see what the reaction would be.
It's actually found widespread support within institutions. Yeah. Right? I mean, so, let me give you, if you're talking about IIM, so, leadership at most IIMs have been scrambling to get this done right this academic year. And they're not even mandated.
OBC reservation pushed them for 3-4 years. They don't want to increase 27%, every year 9%, you know, they push like that, 6-7 years away.
I think the larger point that you're making is the following. Has the new quote-unquote constitutional amendment made caste visible? I think it actually has, because the old meritocracy argument where caste was hidden, suddenly that was but in terms of what this means, I'd argue that it actually undermines
This was an excellent start because you were here as well as
you. Thank you for the opportunity.
I think this talk should happen across, especially since we're in the United States. I mean, Colombia, you immediately wrote to me, and I really would like to have people to speak on this issue, because this issue is actually something that is going to explode many myths, especially from the author's mouth, because he's been in institutions for so long, and also coming with this international perspective. And again, I appreciated the theoretical foundation of cognitive segregation, because I think that is a very, very paramount to the way we socialize caste as well as socialize segregation. In addition to that, because your struggle is very important in the community, it's been very difficult for people on a very personal and professional level. Being the lone star surrounded by, hunted by your own colleagues for the kind of work you do and for the constitutional rights, and also on a basic human rights you stand for, and you get called out and kind of misled on a very personal level. I think this has been a very vehement struggle for the fact that we stand in solidarity with the people, and it's very important that we do hear from the Harvard Kennedy School as we stand here with students and faculty as well as when the public is here and activists are here. the French Congress, and on this point, let us also emphasize that there is a lot that we need to collectively achieve, and one of the aims of the lecture series is to interrogate these structures that doesn't exist in the government. And this is a space where we need to dissect and deepen the past formulations, and I think one of the first experiments in this lecture series is that Professor Deepak Malghan. We are having next lecture series on the 7th March. It's going to be included in that London. Professor Gwadi and Singh had offered a book, one of the authoritative biographies of Joseph of Bangal, who was instrumental in the leader of Bangal, instrumental in pushing a book to the Constitutional Assembly, let alone the paradox of Congress that has sponsored it. And so I think that book launch is going to be, the discussion that is going to be here on the 7th March, most likely in the same hall. As we know, the semester has kicked in, and so there has been a lot of issues around management. So thank you so much for bearing with us, because of all the logistical nightmare that we had and we are finding it going on. Final announcement. First of all, I would like to acknowledge you for addressing the Boxers and the Board of Directors, and your members of the President, and as well as Mr. Morajan, as well as members we have produced, as well as Kalista for being in the audience. We have India Conference coming next weekend. It's one of the benchmark events of Southeast or India related events at Harvard. So we are Boxers and Group is for the first time. There are two panels directly engaging with that has never happened before. And the topic is, as it is the judiciary in India grammatical? Does it offer justice? And we have a key panel of Rohit Jain, professor at Yale, we have Vidit Lokshadri, ILS colleague Tuli, we have Kiriba Mindasami, he is an advocate of Supreme Court, as well as we have Anurag Bhaskar, LLM student, as well as the columnist. The second is, can popular cinema break the caste barrier in India? And we have Star Travel, we have Paranjit, director of Kala and Kabali coming. We also have Nagraj Manjile, the director of Sairat and Sairi Tamindan. We have former Minister of the Earth, Adalit herself, Niharika Singh. And of course, we have a Hindi filmmaker and producer who himself has stormed sense of both Bhumak Murli, Murli seldom gets any talk from a reservation and looks at the perspective of reservation affects or does not affect our current region. Thank you so much for being here. Have a good rest of the day.
Correct.